this is our 3D space, x axis, y axis and z axis, and this 3D space, a plane is passing, and it is passing through the point A, and it is also, the normal is perpendicular to the plane. Now we will be finding the equation of a plane passing through a point and a perpendicular. This is our 3D space, and this is our x axis, y axis and z axis. And in this 3D space, a plane is passing, and it is passing through three non-collinear points A, B and C. We'll find the equation of a plane passing through three non-collinear points. Here is our 3D space, x-axis, y-axis and z-axis, and there is a point A in the 3D space, and a line L is passing through the point A and is parallel to B vector. We will find the equation of a line passing through a point and parallel to a vector. This is our 3D space, x-axis, y-axis and z-axis, and in this 3D space there is a point A and point B, and a line L is passing through A and B. Now we'll find the equation of a line passing through two points. Plane 1 has intersected the plane 2. Now, plane 3 has intersected plane 1 and 2. We'll find the equation of a plane intersecting the intersection of two planes. This is our 3D space, x-axis, y-axis, z-axis, and there is a point A in our 3D space, and a plane is passing through the 3D space. We'll find the equation between a point and the plane. This is our normal to the plane. A line is passing the plane, and we'll find the angle between the line and the plane. This is the x-axis, y-axis and the z-axis. And this will be our normal. This will be the plane passing through the normal. For this, we'll be finding the equation of a plane in normal form. Two lines can be parallel, or they can be intersecting. Two lines are called skew lines if they are coplanar and they are not parallel or not intersecting. We will find the shortest distance between two parallel lines or between two skew lines.